Hey everyone, this is Deepak Bari. Welcome to this video. In this video session, we are going to learn how to secure our switch from unauthorized access by providing a password in it. So in the last video, we have seen about and making a LAN by using PC, server and switch. So switch makes an important role for making a LAN. So providing a security of a switch is important. So here is the file which we have used in the previous session. So just double click on it. And this is our the old scenario which we have done in the last video. So as you can see, the amber light is going to green right now. This is the switch's light. Now this switch is open and there is no security in this switch. Anyone can configure and anyone can misconfigure on your LAN. So your LAN, maybe it's not working. So for providing this switch security, just what are the security issues we will face if we ignore this process? So just go to the CLI tab and here is the CLI of this switch. So just give this command enable for going the global configuration mode. So this hash sign, it's showing this is a global configuration mode, and the bracket sign, this is showing this is a user configuration mode. So we are making some changes here. So let's say enable, and let's say we want to open the terminal mode. Okay, as you can see, there is no password in this CLI mode, and if you want to turn off this PC0 by unauthorizing this switch, unauthorized access switch. So I need to select this interface first, that is the fast ethernet 0x1. So just hit down this command interface fast ethernet 0x1 and normally just give this command shutdown, and as you can see, the green light is turned down as and it turns into the red sign. So that means your interface is shutting down. So that means this PC now can communicate with each other. Any one of PC can connect or can ping with this PC. So let's check it. Go to the desktop and open the command prompt and just test a ping. The IP address was our server is 192.168.10.10. Now as you already know, this interface is already administratively down, so no one can ping from here. Okay, so close it. And again, just go to your PC. And as you can see, the configuration mode, the interface configuration mode is already enabled. So give the command here no shutdown for enabling and administratively enabling this port again. Now the red color is turns into amber, and give some time, it will change the amber from green color. Now as you can see, the amber color is turned into the green color, so that means this links is up. So that means this PC can communicate with all the PCs here. So let's repeat that process, the ping. Now you can see this PC can ping from the server and it gets a reply from the server also. So that means we need to provide a security in this switch. So we have two options. first exit from here. So this is the user configuration mode. So just give the enable keyword for going the global configuration mode. And we need to go to the terminal mode. Enter this command into your switch iOS, that is the CLI. And type your enable password. Suppose the password is lorem, that's okay. Exit from this mode and disable this mode. Now we are returning back into the user configuration mode, and we want to just try to enter the global configuration mode by giving this enable command again. As you can see, it prompts the password. If I hit down only the enter key, it again prompts me 3 times. That are the bad secrets. So that means whenever we need to change this in our ports, so it must should be in the terminal mode, and we need to go the sub interface or the interface mode by through the global configuration mode. So as you can see, we can't access the global configuration mode because we already applied the password here. So just give the password simply there, lorem. Yeah, the global configuration mode is opened. Now we can change anything from here, but it's not the better security as I think. So the second one option, which I recommend you to use the secret key instead of this password only. So just go to the terminal mode again, give this command configure terminal and type here enable secret and the password whatever you want, because there is a reason because of it. So let's see the reason first. If you want to show this password in this CLI, or if anyone want to know the password of the CLI so they can see clearly in the text mode. So just type this running config command from here, and whatever the configuration which is running instead, so it returns all the configuration of this iOS. So as you can see, the enable password is set to the lorem, so anyone can know your password. So that means your password is also not encrypted right now. So for encrypting this password, we are using the enable secret command. Okay, so first we need to go to the configure terminal mode and give the enable secret, and in this time I'm choosing the my secret password is ifsum. So then exit again, then again from exit from here also, then give the enable command again for entering the global configuration mode, and it requires a password here. So if I give the password lorem, so it prompts again, but we already assigned the password in lorem, but it's not working at all because we are using a super secret password here that is already encrypted. So if you give ifsum here, so it allows us to open the global configuration mode. So if we want to see the password of the iOS which is from the running config, so just give this command, so running config. Now this is the password which we have already set, which was lorem, and the secret which was ifsum, and as you can see, this is already encrypted in some format. Okay, so no one can what was the password, what exactly the password of it, and unauthorized access, no one can access this password from here. So only admin can know this password. So by doing this process, you can secure your switch from unauthorized access. Okay, if I exit from here again and give the enable key again from entering the global configuration mode, you need to give the password here. That was the ifsum, which was the super secret password. That means already encrypted password. So that means the difference between the only the simple password and the secret, the given the secret key, they work same, but the password which stores the clear plain text in your iOS and the secret which encrypts your password into their logic. And don't forget to give this command copy running config to startup config. That means this command does the save the running configuration file to startup configuration file. So just hit the return key or the enter key of your keyboard and it will save. Now you can easily access your terminal from the CLI mode or telnet or SSH, wherever you want, but you need to give the password which was set the ipsum, not the lorem. If you give the lorem here, so it will not work because it was the plain text and your iOS does not prefer to plain text. It's if it is available the secret, that means your encrypted password here. So just give the ipsum here so you can access from here, and you can administratively down any kind of interface here. So just take a look of PC2. So if we are going to administratively down, so we need to go to the terminal mode first. So by doing that, we need to give a command, as you know, the configure terminal command, and select the interface that is the fast ethernet 0x3. Oops, interface first ethernet 0x3, this one, and give the command shutdown. Now you can see the changes. The PC2 lost their connection with the switch and the other connections also. So administratively you can monitor, you can do anything from the switch here. You can control over all the LANs and you can do more things about, and you can do more things with the switch, but we are not going too deeply in this lesson. So we will cover all those things in the later videos. So I hope guys you understand why we need the password here. And so make it restore again. Just keep the enable key. Just keep the key shut down again, the command. And it will turn into the amber light first. Now red light turns into the amber light. And the amber light will turn into the green light. That means it gets your link. I hope guys you understood why we need to give the password in the switch whenever we create a LAN or whatever we need for the administrative purposes only. So still, if you have any questions, so you can comment out within the box right down below. And thanks for watching and see you in the next video.